Hello, my name's John Behrman. I'm a senior mobility engineer working at Whizz-Kidz. Today we'll be taking you through just some quick and easy maintenance techniques for your wheelchair. So now we're going to talk about the different types of controllers on your powered wheelchair. There are many different types that are used, but our main two are from two different companies. We have the RNET and the VR2, and we also have controlled dynamics, but they pretty much do the same thing. You have quite the same sort of standard buttons on the remote. We have the on-off switch, we have a horn, we have a mode button, and we have two buttons that control the different types of speeds or settings within your actual remote itself. You'll hear it, I call it a remote. It would be called a controller, a remote control, all different types of names for it, but primarily it's just the thing that drives your chair is the best way to think about it. This can cause us quite a few issues when your chair breaks down or something goes wrong with it, as the remotes will all give you different flash codes. So the strobing light on your VR2 or your RNET remote will mean that your chair is simply just too far in tilt. So if I put this chair into tilt, we put it back too far, the light starts to flash. It simply means that your chair has gone into a creep mode because it's keeping you stable, because there's too much tilt on the chair. Simply take the chair down until the lights stop flashing or strobing, and then you're ready to go at your set speed. This applies to also the riser on the chair. So if you have a riser fitted to your chair, if you come up off that sensor that's fitted at the back of the chair, it will then put you into creep mode. It's just to keep you safe when you're driving the chair. Take the chair right back down again, gets rid of that flash, and you're ready to go. So a scrolling light within the power indicator can mean that the remote is locked. You simply have to hold the remote back till it beeps, push it forward till it beeps, release the remote, and it's unlocked. If you see a rippling light on your power gauge, this can mean that just the joystick is displaced when you've turned it on. So you may find that you're leaning on the joystick, you've turned it on, it wants to be back in the center to drive effectively. Just let go of it and you'll be able to drive. If that doesn't, then just turn it off and on again and you're ready to go. So flashing on the battery gauge can mean different things. If you have three lights flashing, it can indicate there's a fault with the left motor. If there is five lights flashing, that means there's a fault with the right motor. Other flash codes can indicate different problems. Just make note of them and let us know. You may have a dynamic system fitted to your power chair. The indicator will be a green flashing light. It may be a green spanner flash as well. If you have a five flash, it may be that your left motor is faulty. If you have a six flashes, it may indicate that your right motor is faulty. Or you may have seven flashes, which indicates that there is low power in the system or there's a fault with the batteries themselves. Regardless of the type of remote you have on your power chair, it's really important to take note of the lights that are flashing, how many lights are flashing, and report that to customer services so we can then diagnose the fault within your power chair. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to see similar videos like this, please check out the Whizz-Kidz website where you can find lots more information.